gonna clean my room until I got high. I was gonna get up and find the broom, but then I got high. My room is still messed up, and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, hey, cause I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. La da 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 da.
What's up, YouTube? And welcome back to my channel. First things first, thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you follow my Snapchat, you may have already seen that I did release a little sneak peek of what today's video was gonna be, and that is a room tour. Are you guys happy? Are you happy? Because I'm happy. I'm like super happy. I've been wanting to do this for so long. I just renovated my whole entire room, so here we are! There are still a few things that I still have to change in my room. Like, for example, I still have to get a bong shelf. So my bongs are just still all over the place, kinda. Let's just say, let's just put it that way, alright? But let's get started. Now, I know what your question is. Was that a dick bong? Was that a bong dick? Were you hitting a freaking dick? Yes. Yes. My answer to all of your question is yes. Yes. I bought me a dick bong, and I was hitting that dick bong. Long story short, I was watching Mac Diesel's video, and she had her dick bong, and every time I watch her videos and she has a dick bong, I just love that bong, because like, oh, it's coming. Do you see that? I don't know if you see the smoke coming out, but it's coming. Mac Diesel with a dick bong, I'm always like, I want a bong like that. I want a dick bong, because y'all know how much I love dick. Y'all know how much I love weed. So I went to the Lehigh Club, and I found a dick bong, but because I live in Canada, to get it from the USA to Canada, like, altogether would cost roughly around 130, 150 Canadian dollars. And I was like, yeah, I'm not dropping that on a dick bong. Anyways, I decided to leave that alone. That same day, my mom asked me to go to the mall. And in that mall that we usually go to, there's this one bong shop where I've been buying bongs from, actually, lately. I bought two bongs from there. And I bought this mouthpiece. So we went to that shop, and I'm like, okay, whatever, might as well just check out the shop. So while I'm buying this mouthpiece, I'm like talking to the girl in the store, like, you know, we're doing our thing, paying for it, you know. Me and the girl at the counter were talking, like, she was really cute, and I see, like, right behind her head, there were three of these. A pink one, a green one, and this multicolor one. So I was like, wait, hold on, is that a dick bong? I just posted that this morning on my story, like, what? What? Did that just come just because I posted it on my story? Like, so, you know, I need to buy one, and she chose the color for me because it's beautiful, and plus I was looking at this one too, you know, like, I don't know how she chose the color that I was looking at, so anyways, so, you know, we both together chose this color, and it's beautiful. It's really, really beautiful, and I've been hitting it since I got it, and I can't stop sucking it. It's the only dick I suck now. This video, you already know, is about to be a nasty video. Anyways, it is the best dick ever. Why? Because it has a huge ass tip. Like, is your dick tip that big? Is your penis hole that big? Is it? Please, if it is, let me know in the comments down below, because I know nobody's penis hole is that big. So, its penis hole is really big. The mouthpiece fit in it. Another thing that's really cool about it, it's silicone. They didn't have any glass, but it's okay. Silicone is fine too. So, it's silicone, so obviously you could change it, you could twist it, you could do whatever the fuck you want with it. Another really cool thing about it, the head comes off. The head comes off, guys. Guys, the head comes off. Does your penis head come off? Try unscrewing your penis head right now and let me know if that comes off. If it does, let me know in the comments down below. Before we begin, I'm just gonna suck this dick one more time. Cheers!
The first thing we see before even coming into my room is just my jacket rack. Over here, I usually keep the jacket that I'm using and my work fanny pack. Close the door. Just so I have more space. I have a bra hanging at the door. I have slippers right there. More slippers. A beautiful two-pack portrait that I got from Walmart. So I got the frame. Altogether was like $13. A beautiful picture of the king and the queen. I got plants, bongs, pipes, torches, more pipes, books. We're actually gonna go through all of this. I'm just showing you at first how it looks. I set up a little dab station so we can dab. This tapestry comes from Ethiopia. This one comes from Egypt. And so does this one. And this one comes from Tanzania. This comes from Mush. Yeah, I just got it from Mush.
Initially, I sent me up a little dab station over here, but now that I think about it, the gas mask is here. So while we go through my library, I'm just gonna be hitting the gas mask.
So I showed you on the very, very top shelf already, and I'm just gonna take a hit. Then I'm gonna show like two shelves, and then I'm gonna take a hit again, and then two more shelves, and then I'm gonna take a hit again. Okay, hold on, I'm not doing this right. All right, we're back again for the second try. Because the first one didn't work out as good.
I can't see shit. Whew. Those were some shitty hits, and I don't know why, but hopefully the next one is better.
All right, so this all over here is the whole entire Sister Soulja. Well, I'm missing one of the books because I let my best friend borrow it. She's reading it. She'll give it right back to me when she's done with it. I have some Haile Selassie, Black History books. Oops, my pen fell. I think I have, this is a Nelson Mandela, actually. Yeah. Oh my god. Okay, I'm not gonna pull anything out. I'm not gonna pull anything out because the pipe keeps falling. But this is The Power of Now, I believe. Yeah. Nelson Mandela, Black History books. I think this is Thug Life. Marcus Garvey, Rastafari books, The Four Elements, Tupac Shakur. Biography, because obviously it's Tupac. I have the Cabernet Guest at the very, very top because you always want that to be your highest book. This is just a journal where I write video ideas and my dreams most of the times. This book I actually found at the bus stop and it intrigued me because it was a black book. These are like books that I never really read, to be honest, that like I got somehow, and I do remember most of them I bought, not even some of them I bought. These were given to me back home. These are actually Italian reading books. Yep, this I bought, The Art of War. This is actually my ex-boyfriend's book. I would gladly give it back to him, but he acts like a child, so I don't think he needs this because this is an adult book. I don't think he'll be able to read that, so I'm just gonna keep that until he grows up, and then like, you know, he'll be able to like understand it and then he can read himself. What else do I have here? This I got for free from the book library. Some of these I found actually in free libraries, like, you know, those free libraries when you go outside. What is this? I think I was writing in this book. I don't know, maybe it's an idea book. I don't know. I have a sex Bible full of sex positions. I was actually writing a story in this. It was like a erotic story. I have a good like two or three chapters on it. These, I don't know, I think free libraries my father gave to me. I don't know how I got these books. This I had for my birthday, 15th or 16th birthday. My coworker bought it for me. This one I bought it for school, and this one I bought it for school as well. I don't know if this camera angle is good, you guys. Like, I hope it is, because I'm not about to do this all over again. I usually have my gas mask right here, and you know, the bong over there, you've seen that already. My eyes. You see this eye is literally tearing up. This eye is teared, and then this one is dry. Okay. Anyways, moving on. So these two shelves are usually like my school shelves. If you didn't know, I'm studying at George Brown College to become an architect.
Hopefully I'm graduating soon.
So, all right, so let's just start. I have salt over here that I usually wash the bongs with. Tape, architect tape. I have some architect drawings, a table like to cut, some rulers, architect type rulers, obviously, cause I'm an architect. I have some T-squares. No, not T-squares, what do you call these? Triangle.
I have some triangle rulers. I have two of them. So I have these two drumsticks. My grade 6 music teacher gave them to me to like drum at home, like, you know, learn how to like do the drums. And I never gave them back to her. And like, yeah, I have drumsticks. I like to play the drums. I love playing the drums. I'm always like, if you see me down the road, like, if you know me and you see me down the road or you see me dancing or like do my little 2-1-2, I'll always be like playing the drums because that's my thing. I love playing the drums.
I have this incense holder that me and my ex got the same. Like, not the same, but like matching ones. This was his. Actually, it's broken because he broke it all off.
I broke this part. I broke the head. But he broke the tail. And yeah. He got a blue one and I had like this pink dragon.
Actually, I still have my pink one. This is an artist set. There's like pencils and crayons and like all that kinds of stuff.
I have a student card. Oh, actually, I have more student cards. Let me show you all my student cards. So,
because I really, really wanted to show off my glow up, I'm just gonna do them like this. So grade 9, 10, 11, 12. This was like in between grade 11 and 12 because it was like a summer school that I did at Humber College. It was a cooking course and I got an extra credit for that. So this was like in between. And then this was my first year of college. So like this year. Guys, do you see that glow up? Do you see that damn glow up? Like, this was my cutest one. But do you see that glow up? Yo! Oh, also, grade 9 picture, this is what happened. I got suspended like after 4 days of grade 9, and what's it called, I guess they gave me like 2 weeks. They wanted to give me 4 weeks, but because it was only 4 days of school, they gave me only 2 weeks. And in those 2 weeks, we were supposed to take our,
you know, I missed the student picture obviously, and when I came back I was right on time for the retake, but I didn't know when it was because I had just missed two weeks of school, and like, you know, nobody told me that it was a school retake, and I didn't wash my hair that day, so that's why my hair looks this crazy in this. But that was the last time that you'll see me with like normal hair. I used to love my hair, but it doesn't look good in this one, you know, because I need to wash it. And I didn't even know that it looked like that. I didn't even look at myself in the mirror before taking this. I just took it, and I was probably high too. But yeah, this was my first set of dreadlocks. I got it in grade, like right before grade 10. I had it for like 8 months, and then I cut it off. Well, my mom made me cut it off. And then this is when I first got my second set. So this picture was taken in August, I believe. And I got... No, sorry. The picture was taken in October. And I got locks in August. So I was like 1 or 2 months in. Or maybe it was taken in September. I don't know, but yeah. I was like barely locked.
Here, there's all my school books. These are the bulbs that I took out of the light. It's somewhere like over there in the middle, right there. And I was like, nah, fuck the lights, it's useless. I don't like those lights, honestly. No, like, I have those and they're good enough. I wish it was nighttime so I could show y'all how it looks at night, but it's not. Maybe tonight I like record a little one block hit or whatever, I don't know. But if you go like on my Snapchat, on my Instagram, you probably know what it looks like. I have a frisbee, some sketchbooks, notebooks for school, bank stuff. This is paper that I draw on. I have to go pee. And then over here, I just keep like a whole bunch of random
stuff. I don't know why I had to announce that I had to go pee, but like, I just had to. And like, I couldn't hold it no more. So anyways, I ran. And then I took a little break to pet my cat, but I'm back. So I finished all of this. I showed you my slippers. I showed you everything. Actually, I'm just gonna show you what's in my purse just because I'm showing you what's everywhere. So let's see what's in my purse. This is my like everyday purse. My ex-boyfriend got this for me. I think it was like my 18th birthday, I don't remember. But it was like from Kensington Market. I seen it and I loved it and I was like, okay, I'm gonna get it. And he was like, it's okay, I'll pay for it. I was like, no, you don't have to. But you know, it was my birthday, so he still did it. So in this like front pocket, I have a receipt from FreshCo. In the big packet, I have, what do I have? I have my Stitch wallet because y'all know how much I love Stitch. Also, I was gonna wear the Stitch onesie because, you know, I have my Stitch slippers and like, you know how much I love Stitch. Anyways, I was gonna wear the Stitch onesie, but because I already have a video like that and, you know, I didn't wanna wear the same thing again. I just wanted to, I just wear this because, you know, I didn't wanna wear like clothes because it's my room. Like, this is a chill video. I wanna show y'all that, how my room looks. I wanna show y'all like how I chill usually, you know? So stay weird. I have a few money in here. I don't know how much I have. I'm broke. Oh, I have a bus ticket from November 30th, 2019. I have a little liner. And honestly, girls, don't be afraid to show this off because everybody has liners, okay? We don't control our period. And unfortunately, we have to pay for that shit. So I'm going to show off that I paid for this because this world is so fucked up that makes me pay for something that I need. Not something that I want, but something that I need. And I'm going to show it to y'all. I don't care if y'all like it or not. Anyways, I have a Rec Room card. Actually, this stuff has some tickets on it. This guy took me on a date there and like, we went and like it closed before we could finish playing and we still have to go back. I have my debit card. I got a Lazenza card. It's actually a club member card because y'all know how much I love Lazenza. I think I also have a gift card from Lazenza. It's not in here. It's in my thing, but I have a $50 gift card that my ex-boyfriend's mom gave to me for my birthday. My like 18th birthday. Yeah. I don't remember it, but probably 17th or 18th, I don't remember. But yeah, she gave me like $50 for Lazenza, so she was trying to get her son some. Anyways, we never ended up going because, I don't know, I guess we forgot. I don't remember, but yeah. we never ended up going, so I still have that $50, and I'm gonna get somebody's son some. Or daughter, who knows. I have a little baggie because you never know when you're gonna need some, right? Like, you're always out, and some friends like, yo, can I have a gram? Like, you know, I have a little baggie, so I got you, got that. I have like my passport picture from when I was 13. I don't even look 13, but yeah, I'm ugly. I'm not even gonna show it like properly, but yeah, it's ugly, ugly, ugly. What else do I have in here? I have some spare change, a lot of spare change. If you're not from Canada, this is what our coins look like. They are like this. But I think most of my audience is from Canada actually, or maybe USA, I don't know. I have some dollars. I got some dollars in my pocket. These are usually like tip money because I work at Glowzone 360, if you didn't know that, which is like entertainment workplace. I host kids' birthday parties and I make a lot of tip with that. I have another receipt. It's a TD receipt. What else do I have in here? I have the thing for the SIM card. I don't know why I have this. I'm going to throw it out. But anyways, I think this is empty. It used to have like $25 on it. I think it's empty now. I'm gonna throw all this stuff out. Like, I need to like really clean out my things. I don't know why I don't. Okay, the next thing I have in here is headphones because everybody needs headphones in their purse. Like, what? Then I got some blunt wraps, chocolate. I have more pads because, guys, I just got my period yesterday and like I went out and I have pads and tampons, and honestly, I'm gonna keep showing this shit off because the fucked up world we live in, I don't need it. I don't want these, but I need them, and I have to pay for this shit. You know how much these are? You know how much they are? Expensive. Expensive as fuck. This is what our government does to us. And then they say that they love the women. How you loving your women? How you loving your people? By making us pay for products that we need, not that we want, that we need, and they even tax us on it. What? That's fucking bullshit. So I'm gonna keep showing it off. I have my period. I'm on my period right now. And I'm gonna tell y'all too. That's more than y'all need to know, but I'm gonna say that. My work mask. Like, yeah. Glowzone. You see, that's where I work at. It's an entertainment place. Guys, shout out. If you wanna check, come check me out. We're really nice. I can't say the prices on here because I never knew this before until I seen another YouTube video, but I can't say the prices and yeah. Come checking me out at my workplace. It's really cool. Glowzone 360. We have two locations, Mississauga and Brampton. You guys should definitely come check it out. I have more blunt wraps. These are vanilla. I have chocolate and vanilla. Then I got my keys. I got these attached to like the little pocket because there's like a little inner pocket. And in the inner pocket, I actually have my tray because it fits perfectly in there. Look, this inner pocket is actually so much bigger than what it looks like. And I have a tray in there. So yeah, that was actually my first tray ever. I made a whole video when I bought that because I was so excited to have it. So these are both in there. And what else is in here? I have another tampon. That's all I have in my purse. Oh my gosh, yesterday I had such a nice ass back massage, and like today I woke up and my day was just so much better. And like even after a back massage yesterday, I felt like, whoa, like I was a whole new person, y'all. Like I just feel so good. Like if you haven't got a back massage in a really long time, let me tell you something, do yourself a favor and go get yourself a back massage.
Alright, so the overall, the library, I got this from IKEA. They actually have it. It's called Lava something, like Lava Bookshelf or something. It's like $30. And it's honestly so nice. You should definitely check it out. If I didn't name these, if I didn't tell you the name for these, I'm gonna tell you them right now. So we got Xeno, Legend, Daisy, Cobra, Jubes, Song, I haven't named that one, Panda, I got some torches. I never named that one. Cheech. She is Nefertari. Genesis. Zion. I haven't named my gas mask, to be honest. So I don't know yet.
Moving on from the door, the library, we have the closet. So we're gonna move right to the closet. Yes, this is a closet behind my tapestry. I used to have like the actual like closet thing, but I ended up like it was like a mirror, and I don't really like mirrors. So as you will see, actually there is no mirror at all whatsoever in my room, and that is not why, because I don't like to look at myself. I know I'm beautiful, the hell, I'm always looking at myself on camera, but it's because I smoke so much, like so much, that a lot of the times I'll just look to the side and I'll see my reflection in the mirror and I'll be like, who the fuck is that? I literally creep myself out because I actually think that there's a next person over there. Like, a lot of the times it also happens when I see my reflection in the TV, and that's kind of creepy. So to avoid that, I just got rid of all the mirrors because I could not hold that. It was a no-no. So we're gonna move on to the closet. For the closet, we're gonna get into the closet. So come on closer. I have lights in the closet, so don't worry about it. We won't be in the dark. Come all the way in. All the way in. Oh! Will you stand? Will it be possible? Yes. We are in the closet! We are in the closet. And I actually love my closet. So, once again, I took off the doors. I unscrewed the top. I don't know if you can see it, but yeah. I unscrewed the top. I unscrewed the bottom. I'll show you like later in the details. And I changed everything around, so let's just park this up. I don't have an ashtray. I'm gonna ash all over my floor. This is my first time smoking out of a moose lab, and honestly, like smoking a blunt out of a moose lab, guys, this is the best. Get you a moose lab. Holy shit. I seen they made like smaller ones for blunts now. I'm gonna wait till they get to Canada first, and then I'm gonna buy one because I'm not trying to buy it online. Anyways, let me take you out of this. Fuck the tripod. Fuck the whole table. We're just gonna get in the closet. Come in the closet. One time I did do a closet hat box. It was really long back. My closet did not look like this. As you can see up there, I put lights. The bar that's up there did not used to be so up high. It used to be like right at the end, like where you see this black part. Yeah, it used to be right there. And right above there used to be a shelf, which was really freaking useless because I couldn't fit anything in there. So I asked someone in my house to help me out, which was my brother. I asked him to help me out and he could not help me out, so I did it myself. I took off the shelf, I took off the bar. There used to be another bar like halfway, so like over here. I took off both of the bars. I brought one of the bars way up there, so as you can see, I don't know if I need to go closer. But yeah, I screwed in that piece of wood, and then I screwed in the bar. And I hung all my clothes up there. Also, I painted it black before, obviously. I painted all my walls black because I feel like black looks better. Anyways, so moving on. I got this from IKEA. I don't remember what it's called, but you can find it in the kitchen section. I have a whole bunch of clothes in here. Like, I have panties, underwears, bras, lingerie, and sweaters, I think. Yeah. T-shirts, shorts and tights, t-shirts, pants and sweatpants. Over here I have all my bikinis and, like, you know, things to go over it. Oh, this shut off. Anyways, we're gonna leave it right here for now.
The famous hat that you see in the logo. I'm actually wearing the shirt too today. This AC Milan ball is not an actual soccer ball, but
it's like one of those for collection that you put like on a shelf. I still haven't got a shelf for it yet. Yeah, my father got it for me because this is our favorite team. I also have the scarf.
We've had this for actually like over 20 years. Oh, hey, I had an ashtray in here. I could just use this ashtray. Okay, I'm gonna use this ashtray. I'm gonna spark that up. I'm gonna spark this up again and use this
ashtray. On this side, I have pillows that I usually put out when, you know, I open up my bed.
I got this shoe shelf from Amazon, and honestly, it builds, and you can build it as much as you want. There's actually more parts in there that I didn't build because I didn't need, but yeah, I have all my shoes in here. Most of my shoes, I think. I don't even wear these shoes. Like, these are just like heels and like the shoes that, oh, these I wear in the winter time. Actually, right now, because it's snowing already, so I'm gonna pull those out like tomorrow. yeah, that's the rest of like, oh, let me ask this. I'm just gonna put it down. Behind there, I have the first skateboard that I ever got my best friend. I got it for her for Christmas, but it was a really like not good skateboard, so I upgraded it. Like, I gave her some nice trucks and we made it nicer. Now we have a nice skateboard for her. Right here, there's my skateboard. It's a Santa Cruz. Obviously, it has my favorite colors on it. I got this from school. That's like a board that like to draw on it. Like, it's like a T-square basically. Yes, it's a T-square board. This is a bag full of nasty things. There's a BB gun because I just love guns. But yeah, there's handcuffs. I have a rope. Sex board game. I don't think it's like YouTube related. This is more for my OnlyFans. I don't actually have an OnlyFans. In here I have jerseys and from when I did that kitchen program, so I have like all like that kitchen stuff and more jerseys. And this is my vinyl record collection. So since we went through all of my book collection, we're gonna go through my vinyl record collection. This is a lava rock. So I actually got it from the volcano in Pompeii in Italy. If you melt it hot enough, this actually becomes lava. So pretty cool. We're done with the closet and I'm gonna move on to my starting off. I just have a dream catcher. I used to have it in the middle, but after I got this Rick and Morty tapestry from Wish, you know, I just put it on the side and kind of looks cute over there. This is the couch that opens up into a bed. I'm not gonna open it up right now, but if you have this couch, it's from IKEA. I don't remember how much it was. My mother actually got it for me because, you know, birthday gift. And yeah, for my birthday, because she knew I was renovating my room, so she just got me. This is what it looks like in front of the couch. I'm not gonna get to that side just yet, but we're gonna stick to the couch.
If you didn't know, now you know I'm on the couch. I set me up my little dick bong on the couch, so this is gonna be the station for the couch. Cheers.
I realize there's not much explaining to do over here, but there's a lot of explaining to do over here. I'm just gonna put this blunt right here, so we're gonna spark it when we get over there. And we're gonna do this session for right now. Fell from all the way over there. Literally. And I thought it fell somewhere here. And I was looking for it, and look where it went.
Dang. Moving on to this corner. In this corner, I actually wanted to get that Detolf, like the Detolf cabinets that everybody has to put, like that. You know, it's like a glass cabinet and puts like bongs in there. Anyways, I wanted to buy that one, but IKEA is always running out of it and I cannot find it. And I'm waiting for IKEA to re-up on it. But for now, I just have everything on this sticker table. This is my famous sticker table. I don't know if you've seen it in my first couple of videos. I always used to have this around. Yeah, I love this table. There's just so many stickers on it. It's just, it has so much on it, you know, like so many memories. These are all my bongs. Well, the rest of my bongs from there. Not all of them are clean, and I'm sorry about that, but I'm just gonna tell you all the names for them. Taffy, Vass, Boing, Paul, Marley, Cleo, Steve. I don't think I've named this one just yet. Yeah, I haven't named that one just yet. Jean, back there. Jean. And I know I named that one. Who was that? I named them something. Oh, Halo. I named him Halo. This one, I don't know. I haven't named them just yet, but we'll find the name for it. Probably Turbo. Turbo. Because the inside, it looks like a turbo. I don't know. I'm going to call him Turbo. Do you want to see all my bongs? I don't want to go through all my bongs. There's so many bongs. Anyways, I'm just going to take a hit. Ooh, look at my tail. Guys, look at my tail. Alright, I packed me a hit of gin, and cheers. Do you guys have a place to put your ring lights? Because like I honestly don't know where to put them when I'm not using them, so I just have them chilling in a corner of my room. Anyways, these curtains, I don't know, my mom got for me because she just wanted curtains in here, because I had like those, like, you know, pull up and down ones, but they were broken, so I took them off because I didn't like them, and she wanted curtains, so she put these. I had a towel, actually. The towel worked just fine. So I got this thermometer from Dollarama. So moving on, that's the window. I have this beautiful tree that I think every morning that I look at. Actually, when I first wake up, I don't even see the houses. This is all I see. Because from the way I am when I'm sleeping, like, this is literally the corner that I see, and it's so beautiful. Like, every morning I get to wake up to this beautiful tree, and I'm so blessed because of it. Also, last night snowed as of November 1st, and there's some snow outside. So now this is my desk. Wait, let me show you my desk. I got this desk from IKEA, I believe. The bin, I got it from Dollarama. I actually just changed this, and I got it from like a shop in Woodbine. It's like a warehouse type thing. It's the box that I bought gin in. I also always have it around because I usually go out and I bring them. So, you know, I have an extension with my charger because I'm always recording and my phone always dies. So I need that out. In the desk, let me just see what I have in here. I have random stuff. This, I have some dabs in here, I think. Yeah. We're gonna dab like when we get over there, probably. I don't know yet. I haven't thought about it just yet. But I know I wanna dab in here in this video. Yes. I have dab things, clean, what do you call these? Pipe cleaners, dabs, more dabs. Oh, there it is. I was trying to show this to my friend the other day, but I couldn't find it. This pipe that my neighbor got me. So when I babysit her dog, well, dog sit her dog, babysit. I was learning how to make dread hats. Got a good start. Well, not really, but I'm gonna restart.
I think this is a, yeah, Xbox video game. I'm actually gonna plug in my Xbox right now because I'm so high and I just feel like playing. Anyways, I got bags. Bags. I have so many bags. This is to hold your phone. Confirmation picture. I didn't want not want to confirm, but my parents are really Catholic, so they wanted me to confirm. T-tool. My earrings. I love these earrings. I love these earrings. So beautiful. I got them from Spencer's. Yeah. I have some hair ties in here, but this I got. I actually donated $40 to the ocean, like to help clean the ocean, and they sent two bracelets in there. They were really beautiful. I got this lighter back home in Italy. I think I said where I got all of these clippers from and what's in my stoner box video. So if you want, you can check that out. I got some ground tomato for when I have my food. I usually do some smoothies with that, and it goes down the cramps. Glasses, sunglasses that I never use. Yeah, cover that I never used. This was from a giveaway, Ignite. This as well, from the same giveaway. It was actually my second giveaway ever. This is a sticker. I don't remember where I got this from. I think in here, I just have a whole bunch of just random. Oh, I have one of these because, you know, my grandma gave me this, so I gotta keep this. I have more tampons because I'm a woman. I don't have these things. I have a popper that I got from work. These are really freaking cool. Hold on. Let me see if I can do it with one hand. I don't think I can. Wait, let me just see. Ah! I did it with one hand! I did it with one hand. Yeah, my work is really fun. I get so much stuff. More pipe cleaners. My ex Jilla. Brush trap. Chargers, Kiroko scissors, MP3 from like 2007 or 2009. I don't remember the year, but yeah, really freaking old. This I actually got for Halloween, but I never used. Phones. Oh, I remember this phone. This is actually brand new. Hold on. I need to bring this back to life. What the hell? So I can have a second phone. This is brand new. Okay, I need to charge this. This I gave to my ex and he mashed it up. Now it doesn't even turn on anymore. I got some chopsticks that my cousin got from Tokyo. Beads. Yeah, I have so much random stuff in there. Moving on to right here. I have a jar that one of my friends made for my birthday. And inside, there's just so many baggies, like from all the times I buy weed. That's why right now I just throw them all out. That my ex-boyfriend's mom got for my 18th birthday because she made me a rum cake. So like, you know, I needed to dip it in there just in case. Butane to refill lighters. I do hair from time to time, so this is just to keep all the edges down and everything. I got boxes and boxes. I have some broken glass in there. I'm not gonna go through that. I have Xbox video games, like Xbox games in there. Seeds that I got from Black Rabbit. Like, not that I want it, but I found the neon ones. And I never bought from them ever again. I got a scale. This was to make waist bead. These are shells that I got back home. I just went on a walk one time on the beach. And I just started picking up a whole bunch of shells that I found, and they were so beautiful. And I'm gonna make like so many, like, what do you call it? I'm gonna make waist beads with it. I still haven't got to it, but I will. I promise. This is just a cover for the grinder for when I go out. This is to refill Zippo's. Zippo butane. I have an extra jar. Oh wait, no. I have like, I don't know, every time I have some leftover weed that I'm not gonna smoke, I just collect it in here. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I'm probably gonna make some edibles or some. I don't know. I don't think you can make edibles with burning up. But anyways, I have so much roaches in here. Just roaches and roaches. In all these boxes, I have different like weed stuff. He gave me this laptop. He bought it in 2013, I believe. 2014. I don't remember. Maybe 2015. I don't remember. But yeah, he bought this and then he gave it to me. I've had it for a few years now. This is a salt. Like, I don't know what you call it, but it's like, it's really common. Yeah. And you could change the dimness on it. I usually have it full because it's like really calming. I have this beautiful lava lamp that I got on, that I got from Spencer's, but the lamp inside broke, like the actual bulb inside broke, and when I went to buy a new one, I spent $11 on one bulb that wasn't even the right one because it doesn't get warm enough. So I need to exchange that. I still haven't got to it. This has been like this for 3 days and it still hasn't turned on. I was rolling on this tray, the blunt that we smoked earlier and we're gonna smoke again soon. It was actually in watermelon wraps. We are smoking some Jack Herrera. Look at the Jack Herrera.
So I packed me a little bowl at the desk as well. This used to be my favorite bong since I bought it, and it still is actually because of the design on it. It's kind of like a bandana type of design. At the top it has like, I don't know, like a tribal type thing. I love it. It is a legendary as well. I haven't named this one. It's so beautiful. It also has like stars over here. So yeah, I just love it. I'm getting a little hungry, so I'm just gonna go take a snack break and we'll be right back. Alright, I took a little break, but we're finally back where I left this blunt, so let's spark it up. As you can see up here, I have this beautiful painting that I got from a warehouse in Woodbine. I made that Rastafari flag myself. It's not too hard, it's just painting. These lights I got from Amazon, which are the same ones that I have in the closet. So moving on to the shelf, I just put this bong here so we could hit it. I'll hit it in a minute. Right here, I have a couple trays, rolling papers, blends. These are my first giveaway that I ever won ever, which was the BabTech Bab Vaporizer. Cover to a pipe. I got some lighters. Well, I actually got this from Amazon for like 70 bucks. I have a vape in here, dry herb vaporizer. Over here, I have some jars. This is where I usually put my weed when I have like half ounces. This is usually where I put when I have more than an ounce. Right now I have some Jack Herrera erasers, Keith jar. This is Clementine. I just got it and I didn't change the sticker. Stem jar, hemp wick. I got this from Amazon, 200 feet for like, I think it was like 15 bucks, something like that. This I got from work. I got this. Well, my mother actually got this from Egypt. It's a chain. I do wear it from time to time. I have two ash catchers. I have not used them in a little while, actually. So they've just been sitting here, kind of dirty. A clean stem that I've never used, actually. Brand new. This came with the Ignite giveaway. There was an electric grinder in there that I gave to my brother. I have some pens in here, pencils, scissors. These are for the lights. This I got when I was putting up the mount for the TV. More liners, cards, just different types of cards. Oh, there's Madison's club card. So that was my gift card in my wallet then. Oh, I didn't know. Alright. I have this bowl of like it's a coconut bowl. And it's just full of dirty bowl pieces and stems. This is the only clean bowl piece in there. I have two colognes that I got from Kensington Market. This came from Cuba. And I just put all my incenses in there. Tape.
And just this thing just filled up with random things. Just, I don't know. It has a lot of things in there. Filters from Moose Lab. This is from last night, actually. I took like a few hits and it became like this. And I was like, yikes. And I got some glow sticks that I got from work. In this first drawer, I got Legos, makeup for when my friends get hickeys and they need to hide it, and a Nutella box with my name written on it. I think I got like Nintendos and stuff in here. I don't know where I have in there. There's like a box with something. Waist trainers, some other stuff. I don't know. I don't like touch this part of my room. Like, I just put this stuff in here. This is like that useless, the useless things in your house. You know what I mean? If you know what I mean. This is actually that thing that I used when I did my hair, like the little sink. A tripod that's broken. Sponges. There's like a lot of artsy stuff in here. Play-Doh, a whole bunch of Play-Doh. Yeah, there's like art. There's pictures that I took. I do photography from time to time. Actually, if you'd like to see them, I will link my photography accounts in the comments down below. There's some really good pictures in there. Like, yeah, I'll just tag. If you're trying to see the rest of my photographs, you can just check out my Instagram. I have an Instagram photography account. I'll put it in the description down below, so you can definitely go ahead and check it out. I have some baby pictures. Yeah, this is like a baby album. Aw, baby me and my butt. Because everybody loved my butt since I was a kid. But look at me, I was so cute. Hold on. I want to open it and see if there's more cute pictures. Aw, look at me. I was so adorable. That's my brother. Pulling up the middle finger because he's always mad at me. I was so cute, you guys. Oh, it's empty. Aww. Okay. In this next one, I just have like random clothes that I use like on a daily, basically. And in this last drawer, I got a vibrator. I got headbands, like head stuff, basically. I got African shea butter. I got more hair ties. I got more like combs and things for when I do hair. I have Vaseline. This is like a thing to make things smell nice. African soap, perfume, coconut oil, cream, more cream. I don't really use this cream. I honestly just had it because my ex-boyfriend used to get really ashy. So like, yeah. These, I don't know, they're brand new. My auntie gave to me. A perfume that my brother got for my birthday. I use this on my locks. I will actually make a lock tutorial. I use this when I retwist some other people's locks. This my auntie gave to me. More black soap. Beads, gelatin. More hair stuff. Tampons, pads. These like hygiene things, basically. Oh, hey, look, there's lube. There's like wax, like for your edges. There's hemp facial mist. So when your face gets dry. Alright, just to refresh you. More perfume, Guerlain things. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff in here.
So this chest of drawers was from IKEA as well. My mom bought it for herself and then she didn't need it anymore in her room because she redecorated and she just gave it to me. So I don't know how much it was. Cheers. Smoked out of a little tiny bong in so long. Oh my god.
So moving on from this area, going to the bottom, I have this blanket that my mom made for me. It's not on the ground, it's in my cat's bed. This is his old bed, actually. He has another one. It's in the stairs right now, like, not in the stairs, but, like, in the hallway. And, like, he doesn't use this one. Every time he comes to my room, he always comes on my couch. So, you know, I just put my blanket on there. This hat my neighbor made for me. I just got this TV from Walmart. That I got from Walmart as well. That I don't remember where I got it from. I've had it for a few years now. My neighbor made me that. My brother gave me that. And this whole wall now, I just want to put like a whole bunch of hats. But like, I don't want to like buy hats. I want to like, you know, like if people make me hats or like, you know, if somebody gives me that. Excuse me. If somebody gives me a hat or whatever, you know?
This last corner, I just have my slippers over there and, you know, this table. I usually don't keep nothing on this table, like just random stuff. But right now, just because of this video, just for the purpose of this video, I set me up a little dab station, you know, because we're gonna dab. And my TV is right above there, so we haven't gone really far. This is pretty much it. I really need to get an e-brake, guys. Like, I'm so bad with that. I'm literally so bad when it comes to dabs, like, I can't, I really can't. So this was it for my room tour. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching and peace out. See you next time.